This short video will look at how to prepare a cost of goods sold budget. You'll notice on the cost of goods sold budget you have three columns, and each column represents one of your three inventory accounts that you have in a manufacturing business. If you're looking at what you're going to sell using first in, first out, the first product that you're going to sell is that what was in your finished goods inventory at the beginning of the period. So the first line on your cost of goods sold budget is your beginning finished goods inventory. Then the next thing you're going to sell is that you already had in process at the beginning of the period. You're going to complete that and sell that, so that's the next line. Once you've sold your finished goods and that you already had in process, the next thing you're going to do is start from nothing, start from scratch, use your materials, your direct labor and factory overhead to create a new product. So the third column and the third number on your statement is your beginning direct materials inventory. Then once you get to that point, you're going to go through the process of an inventory calculation for each of the three inventories. So direct materials, we start with our direct materials inventory. After we've completed, we add to that our direct materials purchases, which will come from your direct materials budget. And that gives you your direct materials available for use. Subtract out from that your ending direct materials inventory, and that's going to give you the cost of your direct materials placed into production. So if you recall, when we place materials, labor, and factory overhead into production, they move into work in process. So that's our next step, what we do here. We have our direct materials going into production. We have our direct labor, which is going to come from the direct labor budget, our factory overhead, which is going to come from the factory overhead budget. We add the three of those together. That's our three manufacturing costs. And when we add them together, we move them into the work in process column. So we add with those manufacturing costs, we go back and pick up the beginning work in process inventory, and that gives us the total work in process for the period, the total product that went through our work in process. And we subtract out from that what's still in work in process, our ending work in process inventory, to get the cost of goods manufactured. Notice I said manufactured. That means it is completed. And where does it go once it's completed? It goes into finished goods inventory. So we take the cost of goods manufactured, add that to our beginning finished goods inventory, to get the cost of goods available for sale. Once we have the cost of goods available for sale, subtract out your ending finished goods inventory, and that's going to give you the cost of goods sold. And that cost of goods sold is going to go on your income statement. One other thing that I would like to point out, and this will be important when you're doing your project, if you take if you want to find out how much is in your finished goods inventory, you're going to take this cost of goods available for sale and divide that by how many units you had available to come up with a cost per unit, and then multiply that cost per unit times the number of units in your finished goods inventory to get this number. And then you're going to come up with your cost of goods sold.